We've been calling it the Maple Project.
Something like maple syrup production, almost instantly people saw the potential.
You taste something that, oh, let's just say it's a Northwest taste, right? It's got a little bit of vanilla to it. It seems to be a little bit more complex. We're going to visit our bigleaf maple stands.
So I'm tapping into the sapwood.
When it's really cold, nothing's happening that we can see. And when it's really warm, very little sap is flowing. But when we get cold nights, warm days, then we're pretty sure we're gonna get a run of sap coming. So in the tubes, it's the sap that's coming from the trees. That flows by gravity downhill all the way until it drops right into the tank here. The raw sap, it doesn't smell exactly like water, but you definitely can smell that it's, you know, it's biological.
You only have 1% sugar in there, and so mostly it is water.
We might need something like 40 to 80 gallons of tree sap to be able to make a gallon of syrup. Inside the sugar shack is the evaporator, the reverse osmosis system, everything we need to actually process raw sap into a final syrup product. We're finishing off the syrup, and it's 64.7. So I'm nervous because I know we're getting very close to the time when we want to take it off the heat.
I think this is an amazing project. I think this is at the cusp of a really, really big maple syrup industry in the Pacific Northwest. This project is unique in a way. We are talking about generating income from our forests without having to harvest the forest, and on top of it, it protects the streams.
If we can create a system that is profitable for small landowners, we have the potential of increasing canopy cover in Washington State. Yeah, more green cover, and then that does have a potential climate impact.
And this is our label. I'm already satisfied. We proved we can do it. So that part's really good.
Yeah, it's really good.
To do something creative and research-driven was really cool involving maple.